Hello, my dear students. In last 2 days, we have revised the schedule number 1 and schedule number 2. Today, already in the April month, we have completed schedule number 3. Am I right? That is force and its types and motion and its types. Again, I'm going to revise one by one point concept of schedule number 3, that is force and its type. In this today's video, I'm going to just teach you what is the force and effects of force. So can you tell me what is meant by the force? Force is nothing but push or pull. Am I right? It is nothing but push or pull of an any object. Am I right? Of an any object is called as a force. But this is a simple definition. But if you want in a physics or if in a scientific view, then how we can define the force? Force is nothing but a mass into acceleration. Force is nothing but mass into acceleration. Now what is mean by the why this definition is there? Why the force is equal to mass into acceleration? In the last video, we have derived the formula for the force into mass into acceleration by the Newton's second law of motion. By Newton's second law of motion. Am I right? Do you remember this? How we have analyzed? Or how we have derived the equation for the force is equal to mass into acceleration. Then what will be the SI unit of the force? Can you tell me what is the SI unit? Do you remember SI unit of force? The SI unit of the force is nothing but, yes, Newton. And it is written as N. Am I right? Then what will be the CGS unit of force? CGS unit of force, it is dyne. Am I right? It is nothing but dyne. Why the SI unit of the force is Newton? See, by this formula, force is nothing but mass into acceleration. Am I right? So what is the SI unit of mass? That is kg. And what is the SI unit of acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but a velocity per unit time. Acceleration is nothing but velocity per unit time. Am I right? So velocity, what is the unit of velocity? That is meter per second and this second. So it will come meter upon second square. Am I right? So acceleration unit will be meter per second square. Kg meter upon second square. Am I right? So this is nothing but it is called as an Newton. It is Newton. It is denoted by a capital letter N. So SI unit of the force is Newton. So can you be derived for the CGS unit? Why CGS unit of the force is dyne? See, mass we can, force is nothing but M into A. So what will be the CGS unit of mass? Gram. Am I right? So an acceleration centimeter per second square. Am I right? So it will come gram centimeter upon second square. This is nothing but a dyne. So this is the unit of the force. So the next point is that what are the effects of the force? But before that, one dyne or one Newton is equal to how many dyne? Can you tell me? See, Newton means what? Can you tell me? It is nothing but kg meter upon second square. So 1 kg is equal to how many gram? 1000. And 1 meter is equal to how many centimeter? 100. Am I right? So it will come, how many zeros are there? 3. And this 2. So total 10 raised to 5. So 1 Newton is equal to 10 raised to 5 dyne. Are you getting this? So this is about a force and its SI unit. The last point of this video will be the what are the effects of force. So can you tell me what are the effects of force? Yes, we have revised all the points of the effects of the force. The force is, force can change the direction of a moving object. See, when the ball, when batsman hits the ball, am I right? When bowler balls the ball, that time the bats hits the ball. So it can, the ball, the direction of the ball is changed by the batsman. Am I right? So force can change the direction of an object. The next is force can move the stationary object. Now see, this is a pen, am I right? It is stationary. Means stationary means what? It is at a rest position. But when I will apply some force, it will move. It can change the motion of an object. Am I right? If the third point is that when the ball is passing or when the ball is rolling from any surface, we can stop the moving object. Am I right? We can stop the moving object. The force can stop the moving object. It can change the shape of an object. It can change the shape of an object. The force can change the shape of an object. So these are the effects of the force. In the next video, we are going to learn about the types of force. Thank you.